working capital for community needs here in Madison. And he is going to introduce the group that is visiting us from Central and South America. The topic of the talk today is a producer's perspective on fair trade coffee in Latin America. So thank you for being here. I leave with Carlos.
Thank you, Alberto. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Again, my name is Carlos Arenas. I'm the director of Working Capital for Community Needs. We are a nonprofit organization that has been around for 27 years. It was created in Madison by a group of Madisonians. Originally, we have a different name. We were called the Wisconsin Coordinating Council on Nicaragua. But since 1991, we have been working on economic development, and the organization created a social loan fund, originally only for microfinance, and originally only for Nicaragua. But during the last 5 years, the organization has expanded to other Latin American countries, so we changed the name to Working Capital for Community Needs. We kept the same acronym. And the last couple of years, we have also moved from being a social fund that was working only on microfinance to work more most on or to do to work under a broader framework of impact investing. So we are now in the process of expanding to other economic sectors, so like agricultural production. So today, we want to share with all of you the stories and experience of some of our partners in Latin America, specifically for this agricultural financing that we provide. So we have invited three different co-ops, one from Honduras, Raos, and I have here Roberto Gonzalez, who is the general manager of Cooperativa Regional Mixta de Agricultores Orgánicos de la Sierra, Raos, located in the municipality of Marcala, Department of La Paz, Honduras. We have also Eduardo Eras, who is the commercial manager of FAPE Cafés. FAPE Cafés is an association of coffee producers located in the town of, or in the headquarters is located in the town of Loja, in the south part of Ecuador, and near the border with Peru. But they have members in different provinces in the south part of the country. And finally, Mario Rivero, general manager of Asociación de Productores del Valle de Alto Mayo, APAVAM. APAVAM is located in the north central part of Peru, a very isolated area, as you will see in a video that we will show. So all of our partners are just coming from a conference in Portland, the conference of the annual conference of the Specialty Coffees Association of America. All of them produce and export coffee from their members and sell that coffee through fair trade channels to several buyers in the United States and Europe, and they also have local sales. So to give you a better idea of how it looks like in the ground for those producers, we want to show a video from APAVAM, this group in Peru. And after the video, all the speakers will share with you their stories and their experience working on fair trade. So we can and at the end we can have some time for questions and answers. So we can start with the video. This is an 8-minute video. So.
Cuando era más muchacho, no conocía yo las relaciones con los amigos, con la gente. puede más, darnos una educación. Yo trabajaba en el narcotráfico, en la droga, digamos, de la coca. Pero
when I was younger, I didn't have that many connections with people that could provide me with an education. So I worked farming coca plants to produce cocaine. I did that for 5 years and I could not get any benefits. I didn't get anything. So I came back here to San Martin, Alto Mayo, to work with coffee. Now I'm advancing and progressing and making high quality coffee for developed countries. As you can see, I have good lands now, and I have bigger and better understandings, looking more towards the future. My children are being educated, they're going to be professionals, and this is a great progress for me. I have been with Abalam for 7 years, and the benefit that we receive is the best price for coffee. The members receive any support taking out loans or really anything that we need. When I started with Abalam, I was very happy. I even wanted to cry. The first time I sold them my coffee beans, I received a very good value for them. Before Abalam, we used to sell our coffee at 100 soles per 100 pounds. Now with Abalam, my coffee receives on average 150 to 180 soles per 100 pounds. This is a lot better. And so we continue to grow year after year. We are not falling, and if we fall, we have to get back up. We're increasing revenues and learning new techniques, thanks to the engineers at Abalam that are helping and supporting us. Being a part of Abalam has changed the way I work because of the talks that the staff gives, like how we should work, how we should harvest, how we should trim, and that's how the growth occurred. That's how I grew, and that's how I continue to work organically. We can't switch to a different system. I have learned and dived into this new way, and now I can't change the way I work. There are many people that don't understand. I would beg every farmer in this area that works and lives alone to unite and work with a company to coordinate, because together we're stronger, but yourself can't succeed. I would ask from the bottom of my heart to get us together and everything would be very different. We would receive higher profits, become more educated on production technologies, from people that come from many different places and that know how to do it. The things that we don't know, we can learn and apply them. I would ask everyone to form committees, get together, form unions, and we would have better things. My name is María Elvira Mego Delgado. I live in San Martín, Alto Mayo, Peru. I am a member of Abalam, and Agustín is my husband. Organic coffee is easier to grow. We obviously don't have the high yields that non-organic producers grow, but ours is better priced. I have 3 children, and my life has improved because of Abalam. They support us and teach us, and we receive better revenues from our coffee. Now our children are being educated. One of them is in Lima, the other one is going to Peoria. And we are thankful to Abalam for allowing our children to become grown, educated people. I only have primary school completed. My parents were very poor, and they couldn't send us to school because they didn't have enough money.
Los amigos que nos visitan entonces, amigos que venimos trabajando.
These friends that are visiting us are people that we have been working with for a long time. They're representatives of a financial institution. When you guys take the coffee to APABAM, you guys receive a payment. Since APABAM is a small organization, it does not have enough resources to front all those payments before exporting the coffee. This is where the financing comes in. So you guys receive the payment and not have to wait for us to receive our payment when we export it. That is how WCCN helps us front the payments, so you can receive the money the second you hand the coffee to us.
Tres años atrás, yo veía que quería trabajar a lo que es así, solo, independientemente, pero llegando a pensar, no es así. Quería trabajar mediante de una organización.
We got together 3 years ago with APABAM. I used to want to work alone, independently, but then I realized that was not the best way, and I knew I needed to join an organization. I picked APABAM for the good incentives, mainly for my family, to be able to support them. The incentives are better prices and teachings on how to fertilize and trim the property. Those are my incentives for them.
No era así, no tenía crédito, no tenía precio. Y ahora que
Since joining with APABAM, my situation has changed a lot. When I was alone, I didn't have credit, good prices, and now that I have joined, I have ease with the banks and receiving credit.
Por el momento que ves que no tengo plata, ¿no? Digo a veces, allá también es objeción de APABAM, le digo a veces, quiero crédito y todo, ¿sabes? Porque ellos me apagan, aunque ellos no me dan plata, pero ellos lo pagan, la pagan a ver la financiera, lo pagan. Eso, o sea, se ha cambiado a veces bastante.
So that has changed the type of responsibility I have for the money as well, and I return it right away. And I never end up badly with the banks.
No quiero ningún banco saber mal.
Entonces, ponemos la silla. De la... Okay, again, I would like to introduce Roberto González from Raos, Honduras.
Muy buenas a todos. Es un honor estar aquí.
Good afternoon to everyone. It's an honor to be here.
Mi nombre es Roberto René. Trabajo como gerente en la cooperativa Raos en Marcala, Honduras.
My name is Roberto René. I work in Raos, and I'm the director.
Raos es una organización de pequeños productores.
We're an organization of small producers.
Iniciamos en los años 90.
We began in the 90s.
Cuando el café, cuando la producción estaba en decadencia.
When coffee production was falling, was on the decline.
Nuestro objetivo era producir cafés diferente a lo que se venía trabajando, diferente a lo convencional, a lo tradicional.
Our objective was to produce coffee that was different from what had been done up until then, different from conventional coffee.
Empezamos a producir café orgánico.
We started producing organic coffee.
Raos se caracterizó por ser una cooperativa pionera de la agricultura orgánica en Honduras.
Raos was a pioneer in organic agriculture in Honduras.
Comenzamos con 17 productores.
We started with 17 producers.
Actualmente somos más de 250 productores.
Now there are more than 250 of us.
Nuestros mercados principales 98% Estados Unidos.
The huge majority of our market, 98%, is the United States.
La experiencia de trabajar como con la producción orgánica y de la mano con el comercio justo nos ha llevado más allá de abrir nuevas y explorar nuevos mercados.
So it's working with organic coffee and with fair trade coffee that's brought us new markets.
Para nosotros, comercio justo significa estar romper esa barrera, romper lo que se llama el mercado tradicional.
So for us, fair trade means breaking down barriers, getting past what we know as the conventional market, the traditional market.
Una relación directa con nuestros compradores.
It's a direct relationship with our buyers.
Tostadores,
our roasters,
financiadores,
our financiers,
donde los beneficios van directamente hacia los productores.
And the benefits go directly to the producers.
En Raos venimos trabajando con esa motivación y nuestro eslogan es producir un café de calidad y ofrecer una calidad de vida a nuestros productores.
So this is our motivation at Raos, and our slogan is producing quality coffee and producing quality of life.
En cada región en de donde se produce el café, tenemos muchas historias que contar.
In every coffee growing region, we have a lot of stories to tell.
Historias diferentes, historias muy bonitas.
Different stories, beautiful stories.
Y lo más importante es que el café es un producto que ha unido a los países subdesarrollados o en vías de desarrollo, desarrollo con los países desarrollados.
So the most important thing is that coffee has brought together countries that are in development and countries that are developed.
Para nosotros, comercio justo se ha enfocado a transmitir un ambiente no solamente de armonía con la naturaleza, un ambiente de un enfoque social, cultural.
So for us, fair trade is not only means a focus on the environment, but also a focus on society and on culture.
Donde los productores están conscientes de lo que hacen.
And the producers are aware of what they're doing.
Hoy en día, los productores conocen la relación entre que hay la relación que existe con los con el último de la cadena.
So today the producers know the relationship that they have with the end of the supply chain, which is to say the consumer.
Antes de los años 90 que no existía comercio justo en Honduras.
Before the 90s, when fair trade arrived in Honduras,
el café se comercializaba a nivel local.
Coffee was sold and commercialized at the local level.
No conocíamos qué calidad estuvimos ofreciendo de café.
We didn't even know the quality of the coffee that we ourselves were producing.
No conocíamos a nuestros clientes.
We didn't know our clients.
A nuestros financiadores.
We didn't know our financiers.
Y comercio justo vino a abrir y a romper esas barreras.
And fair trade has come along to break down those barriers.
Estamos muy contentos de conocer y de que el mundo nos conozca.
We're very glad to meet the world and for the world to meet us.
Ha sido en la producción de café han habido muchas etapas difíciles.
So we've gone through some hard times in with the production of coffee.
Cuando lo que podemos ver actualmente hay muchas cosas por hacer, muchos retos.
And we can see that there's a lot left to do. There's a lot of challenges still facing us.
Ha habido cambios, por ejemplo, los cambios climáticos afectan mucho a la producción.
There have been changes. For example, climate change has affected our production.
Los precios muy volátiles.
Prices are very volatile.
Pero lo más importante en comercio justo es que tenemos un precio mínimo garantizado.
But the important thing with fair trade is that we have a guaranteed minimum price.
Y le apostamos también a la productividad de café.
And we're betting on the productivity of coffee.
Ahora, conocemos o estamos conscientes de que hay que hacer muchas cosas más como comercio justo.
We know now there are many things left to do with fair trade.
En nuestra organización, como RAOS, hay un trato digno con los trabajadores,
in
con
our,
los productores.
In our organization, RAOS, there's a fair deal, a dignified deal with our producers.
Un precio justo a los productores.
We give a fair price to our producers.
Y bueno, también comercio justo. Educa.
Fair trade also educates.
Va más allá porque educa también a los consumidores.
And beyond that, it also educates the consumer.
También podemos decir que el enfoque social que hay hacia las comunidades donde están las organizaciones productoras de café, hay más empoderamiento porque las organizaciones hacen proyección social.
We can also say that there's a focus on the communities where the producers live. There's a social focus, and it gives them a vision.
Porque las primas de comercio justo lo invertimos en proyectos que van en beneficio a los productores y en beneficio a la comunidad.
Because the payments that we receive for fair trade go towards the producers and towards their communities.
Okay. Thank you, Roberto. Gracias, Roberto. Gracias.
Now Eduardo Eras, Commercial Manager of Pape Cafés from Ecuador.
Buenas tardes con todos.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Gracias por invitarnos a contar nuestra historia de Pape Cafés.
Thank you for inviting us to share our story of Pape Cafés.
Pape Cafés nació en el año 2002 como una alternativa de comercializar café de pequeños productores.
Pape Cafés was born in 2002 out of a desire to provide an alternative for commercializing, for marketing coffee for small producers.
Al inicio la conformaron cuatro acciones de base y en la actualidad contamos con 1,700 familias cafetaleras.
1,700.
Con cuatro asociaciones.
So we started with four associations, and today we have 1,700 families that grow coffee.
En el año igual 2002 comenzamos también con la certificación orgánica y de comercio justo.
We also began in that same year, 2002, to work towards being certified as organic and as fair trade.
Esto permitió que el café ecuatoriano vaya a mercados internacionales.
This allowed Ecuadorian coffee to go to international markets.
Garantizándole un precio digno al productor.
And guaranteed a good price to the producer.
Ya que en esa época el productor recibía un precio por parte del intermediario de cerca de $32 y Pape Cafés logró darle $50.
So at that point, before Pape Cafés came along, the growers were getting about $32 for 100 pounds, and we are able to pay $50 for 100 pounds.
Igualmente, la relación que se ha tenido Pape Cafés con compradores directamente, esto ha permitido que el productor se incentive a hacer un buen trabajo directamente en la finca.
And so also the relationship that we've had, the direct relationship we've had with our buyers, has provided an incentive to growers to produce quality coffee on their farms.
El estar dentro de la certificación Flow garantiza tener ese premio al productor que va en beneficio social del grupo.
So being within Flow has provided us with a guaranteed price, which is a premium price, and that goes towards social activities.
Nuestro reto principal ahora como Pape Cafés es abrir nuevos mercados.
Our main challenge now is to open new markets.
tener café de origen.
Disculpe.
Café de origen.
¿Cómo se dice? Directo.
Directa, café con nombre propio.
Oh, okay. So our main challenge now is to have our own, una marca propia.
Sí, una marca.
Our own brand.
Ya que nosotros tenemos tres zonas de intervención en la región sur del Ecuador.
So we have three regions where we're working in the south of Ecuador.
Ya, actualmente estamos también aprovechando los beneficios de la finca, buscando productos alternativos para exportar aparte del café.
So we're also looking into other products that we might grow, other crops we might grow apart from coffee to export.
Bueno, en el año 2006 empezamos a exportar chifles de plátano al mercado francés.
So in 2006 we began exporting plantains, like planting chips, I guess, to France.
En el año 2011 iniciamos con un contenedor de pulpa de guayaba.
In 2011 we started with a container of guayaba pulp.
Y estamos proyectándonos aprovechar también para hacer chips de camote y de zanahoria blanca.
¿Qué cosa es camote?
Sweet potato.
Oh, thanks. Okay, so we're also planning to get into sweet potato chips and white carrots.
Igual, como FAPE Cafés, estamos interesados también de conocer experiencias de estudiantes que están involucrados dentro del comercio justo y hacerles una invitación para que puedan visitarnos también, conozcan directamente el trabajo.
And we're also interested in learning from the experience of students of Fair Trade, and we would like to invite you to come see and meet us directly in Ecuador.
Van a tener una buena experiencia de conocer directamente el trabajo que hace el productor en su finca.
It would be a very good experience to come see how see these things right directly on the farm.
Okay, gracias Eduardo. Okay, now Mario Rivero, General Manager of APAVAN in Peru.
Buenos días a todos.